In this problem, we have a chemical reaction. Mol carbon and mol hydrogen react. Carbon is a solid in these conditions. So that's the reaction. It says we have a mol of carbon and a mol of hydrogen reacting. We want to know the equilibrium constant. Well, the equilibrium constant is going to be related to delta G. So we can calculate delta G at 298 standard conditions as delta G is a formation of the products minus reactants. Since we have carbon and hydrogen as elements and our heats of formation means forming from the elements, that means these values are zero. So the value for the reaction Gibbs free energy change. It's just looking up in a table the delta G of formation of methane, and likewise the enthalpy change in standard conditions is minus 74.89, also from a table of heats of formation. So the equilibrium constant at 298 is Gibbs free energy change at 298 over RT, and we want to be careful with units, so I'm going to write this as joules per mole and use 8.314 joules per mole for the gas constant, and then the temperature, absolute temperature, 298. So the equilibrium constant at 298 is a large number, 6.97 times 10 to the 8th. So now we're going to make an assumption, which may not be valid over this large a temperature range, but gives us a first approximation. And that's to assume that delta H, heat of reaction, is a constant. It doesn't change with temperature. So this would be a first approximation. If we make that assumption, then we can relate equilibrium constant at two temperatures. In this case, one is 298 and one is 644 centigrade, 298 Kelvin, 644 centigrade. By the heat of reaction and the absolute temperatures. So we calculate it. 6.97 times 10 to the 8th for K1, 298. The formation gave us the heat reaction outright in joules per mole. Gas constant 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin. And then 298 and this temperature 644 centigrade is 917 Kelvin, and so the right side minus 20.33. If I take exponential and calculate this out, K is 1.03. So K is approximately 1. Remember, that's dimensionless, and that's at 644 degrees C. If we wanted a more accurate value, we take into account that delta H changes with temperature. And we would use then heat capacities as a function of temperature to calculate Gibbs free energy at the new temperature, and therefore the equilibrium constant at the new temperature.